It said if you want to push MS Dhoni out of his comfort zone, book his tickets to Australia because it's never been a great venue. We can say that in the Test arena, but not in the ODIs. That's because you remember the 2008 CB series, the bunch of no-hopers turned into achievers. A side with least expectations went on to beat Ricky Ponting's side to win the CB series. Well, first things first, this is the first ever bilateral series between the two, and a lot will depend upon how Rohit and Dhawan start. Their start is very important. Good to see that Dhawan, Rohit and Kohli have registered 50s in the warm-up games. Just helps the team's confidence and theirs as well. MS Dhoni as batsman at number 4, I really doubt. With no Raina, he'll want to come somewhere in the lower middle order. A lot will depend on the spin duo of Ravi Chandran Ashwin and Ravindra Jadeja. They have been in superb form, and Dhoni will hope that their 20 overs will yield a lot of wickets and also control the run flow. No Mohammad Shami, big blow. Nevertheless, they have enough ammunition in that bowling attack. But if the strands look tidy, I really doubt he'll get the game first up. But a lot of eyes and a lot of dependency will be on Ishan Sharma and Umesh Yadav. When it comes to Australia, they boast of a very strong batting lineup, when India have some capable bowlers. But the Australian bowling attack is inexperienced in the absence of Mitchell Starc and Mitchell Johnson, who retired some time back. So even as Australia are labelled as favourites, Dhoni will not be worried because he's always performed when least expected from the side. Expect a lot from this Indian side, and Dhoni will want to redeem himself on Australian soil. A lot to look forward to on the bouncy track of Perth.